Hamptons International Film Festival has been dedicated to fostering talent from the start. For the past 17 years, student showcase director Jeremiah Newton has been working tirelessly to identify some of the best and most innovative student filmmakers the world has to offer. The films in this year's Student Awards program show us that talent has nothing to do with age, and good filmmaking has nothing to do with the dollars available to the director. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce Jeremiah Newton.
It's my 17th year at the festival, and the 17th time I've stayed at the Dutch Motel. Both notable accomplishments, but unlike my motel, student filmmaking is better than ever. That's right, student filmmaking. I'd like to acknowledge one of my judges, Miriam Stern Esquire, who went through hundreds of student shorts. Miriam, can you stand up? Thank you, Miriam. I also want to thank the festival for making this all possible, and especially thank Stuart Matsuna, Karen Arikian, and David Nugent. I think there's a check in here for you guys.
One of the Hamptons International Film Festival's signature programs, the films of conflict and resolution, is a competitive sidebar of work exploring issues of resolution and accountability in the context of global conflict. Too often, war in film is treated as entertainment, and its far-reaching implications in human realities go unexamined. This year's program is a cross-section of eras, nations, people, and filmmaking styles, but each piece contributes to a deeper understanding of war and conflict and of the real lived experience of those involved. The nominees are City of Life and Death, Lu Xuan, director, The Good Soldier, Lexi Lavelle, Michael Ice, directors, How to Fold a Flag, Petra Epperlein, director, My Neighbor, My Killer, Anne Agyan, director, and Rabbit a la Berlin, Bartek Konopka, director. If I mangled those names, I'm very sorry. Let's take a look at a clip.
Your real bare bones job is to go out and kill people. And your world
stops beating now. The more of your people that you see that are hurt or killed, the more it intensifies your desire to kill. I know your mama and your daddy didn't
tell you. For many generations, too many to count, Wilfs have played a serious role in the forming of America and its freedom and its ways. Wilfs have basically been in every war throughout American history. This country just couldn't have a war if it weren't for Wilfs. When this war came, there was no way for me to say no. I had to be there. These colors don't run. I saw it coming beforehand. That's why I had joined the Army just prior to the war beginning. I had to get ready to be up front in the beginning.
Mukoko twari twabimenyesheje mu ngingo z'ingenzi none ku 26 mutarama 2001 inteko ishinga amategeko y'u Rwanda yemeje itegeko rigena imiterere imitunganyirize n'imikorere y'inkiko gacaca inkiko zizaburanisha abagize uruhare muri genocide mu 1994.
Die frisch angelegten Beete und Äcker auf dem Potsdamer Platz lockten ausgehungerte Kaninchen aus der ganzen Stadt an. Doch der Platz konnte nicht alle ernähren. Überall jagte man die Kaninchen fort. Der Zugang zur Nahrung wurde immer schwieriger. Eines Tages geschah auf der Kaninchenwiese etwas, das ihr Schicksal verändern sollte.
And the award goes to Rabbit à la Berlin by Bartek Konopka. I want to accept, Bartek is not here, so I would like to accept this award on behalf of the film.
Hi, I'm happy to announce that this year's new Work in Progress Development Award goes to a film called Harvest, which was created by an organization called Shine Global that shines a light on children's issues around the world. And Harvest is a story in the United States of Mexican-American children farm workers who work on our farms and provide, I'm told, one quarter of the food that we eat. And I'd like to take a look at the clip.
On some days, it feels as if I was in an oven.
The only time we have free is when it rains, you know, and I'll be praying for rain now every day. You know.
So cold out here. When I grow up, I want to be a softball player.
Yo quiero ser un soccer player.
A veterinarian.
I would like to be a lawyer.
My dreams are green. That's how I see my dream, just sugar bee, sugar bee, sugar bee.
Farm work is extremely low paid. Families can't make anything close to a living wage, not even to the federal poverty level. People try and get as many hands out there as possible to bring in a little bit more money.
Es difícil mirar a tu hijo, trabajar, mirándolo, asoleando. Yo tuve que trabajar de 7 años para ayudar a mi mamá. Yo sé que ellos están cansados, sus manos muy feas, su cara. Es triste mirar a ellos.
A child 10 years old can't work at McDonald's. But in agriculture, they can work you 10 hours a day, 7 days a week. What kind of sense does that make?
We were working in a beet field, and a plane flew right over us and sprayed.
Hay en otras partes que hemos visto que hay personas que tienen sus hijos. Que tienen bien sin nariz, sin boca, por los químicos que ellos mismos hacen.
There are 500,000 children under the age of 18 that perform farm work in this country. Up to 2/3 drop out of high school. That dooms them, in many cases, to a life of poverty. Ironically, by the very fact that they're working hard to help out their families.
Cuando yo me voy para Minnesota, me siento mal y también estoy enojada con mi mamá. Ya sé por qué los tenemos que venir para acá. Porque tenemos que agarrar el dinero.
They have no protections. And that is legal in America today. And it's unconscionable.
Yo le digo a mi mamá, cuando tenga niños, yo no voy a trabajar en los files. Nunca.
Thank you. So I'd like to introduce the director of Harvest, Robin Romano. believe he's here. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. We're gonna just,
and I would like to bring on my executive producer and one of the two people who run Shine Global, Susan McClory. And I'm going to let her speak first. Susan.
Thank you so much. On behalf of Shine Global, a nonprofit film production company dedicated to ending the exploitation and abuse of children, we want to thank the Hamptons Film Festival, Kim Brizalara, and the Brizalara Family Foundation for this very unique opportunity of acknowledging our film while it is still in production.
Hi, good evening. Our first juried award today is the Golden Starfish for the best short film. It's presented by Worldwide Biggies and Shine Global. This award receives a $5,000 cash prize. The nominees eligible are Committed, Isolde Ugadotter, director, Dust Kid, Jung Umi, director, Missing, Joachim DeVries, director, Slaves, David Aronowicz, director, and Sparks, Joseph Gordon-Levitt, director. Let's take a look at the clip.
Hi. Já, hún laus og þetta náttúrulega 35 úrst. Ok. Bæ. Það við þetta allar að taka í konum mér. Ok. Hvað þetta bara að búa svona?
Hallo.
Hallo. U bent de moeder van Laura.
Ja, inderdaad, ja. Zeg, waar is de bus?
Ze zijn al weg, mevrouw.
Al weg?
Ja, ze hebben drie kwartier gewacht en gebeld.
Ik was vergeten mijn telefoon mee te nemen.
Ja, vervelend.
Kunnen ze niet even terugrijden?
Nee, dat kan niet.
Domme.
Het spijt me echt.
Ja.
U had op tijd moeten komen.
Ja.
Volgens mij is dat duidelijk gezegd van tevoren.
Ja.
His name is Machete. His age is 15.
Where are you from?
From Rangyang. Rumyul. Rumyul.
Are you from the same village?
Apiam.
Abu. Can you tell me about when you were taken?
Well, I can tell you the same thing. I told the fire department and the sheriff's deputies and the state fire marshal's office, the California Forestry Department, and the guy from Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. What would you like to know?
I wanted to show you the path of the main fire, where it came down west of your place onto the other side of the ridge.
So how'd my house catch fire? Is that the question? How about sparks, Joe? The wind blows sparks over the ridge from the brush fires in Boca Chica, and they land by my house. You buy that? Can I get a Manhattan?
Or a
rabbit or coyote caught fire.
Hey.
And ran like hell right through my yard. Hey. Otherwise, I have no idea. Who does a girl have to... Joe, I watched my house go up in flames. I might have stayed till it burned down. I don't know. Maybe not.
Dust Kid, directed by Jung Umi. Jung Umi is in Korea at the moment and couldn't be here, so I will be accepting on her behalf, and she did send you all a message. Thank you so much for inviting Dust Kid to the Hamptons International Film Festival and giving me your Golden Starfish Award. I wanted to go to the Hamptons and meet American audiences there, but I couldn't make it. I wish I could attend the award ceremony. I am really happy to receive this award. I really appreciate those who support my film and work with me. I hope to be able to visit with my next film. Thank you very much.
Winner of the Golden Starfish Award for Best Documentary receives $5,000 in cash and $5,000 worth of in-kind services. The nominees are Big River Man, John Maringuin, director, Long Distance Love, Magnus Gurton, Mugabe and the White African, Lucy Bailey and Andrew Thompson, Videocracy, Eric Gandini, and Waking Sleeping Beauty, Don Hahn. Let's dance.
This is Martin Strel, the most famous endurance swimmer in the world. He's the only person to swim the Mississippi and the Yangtze rivers. Now in 2007, he will be attempt to be the first person to swim the Amazon.
This is Mike Campbell, my father-in-law. There's a lot more to him than perhaps first meets the eye. Mike's much more at ease back on the farm, checking the mango crop or teaching the children how to fish. It's quite surreal that someone who at heart is as gentle as Mike is about to take on a man who has brought death to thousands. In a few minutes' time, Mike will be facing a dictator in an international court.
Thirty years later, the television of the president has multiplied into a media empire and made the president of television the president of the whole country. For us who grew up with it, it's been a lifelong experience. You can't make sense of it from the outside. You have to get closer, deeper, inside of it to grasp it.
This is one of our animators here. This is Ron Clements. He's working on a scene of the widow from The Fox and the Hound.
Tragically, here is Mr. Donald Musker.
Thank you, thank you.
Another animator here at the Magic Factory.
This is Clint. He's a directing animator. I've been here since 8 o'clock this morning. Hi, Tim.
This is Tim Burton, another one of our people here.
Ron Miller knew that Walt's guys were retiring fast. He had to raise a new crop of animators, but he was cautious about it. He got burned 5 years earlier when he entrusted a charismatic animator named Don Bluth to lead the department. But Bluth polarized the animators. Some adored him as the messiah of animation, and others thought he was just another Walt wannabe.
So the winner is Long Distance Love by Magnus Gurton. Thank you. I believe we're also...
Yeah.
حسيت انه اشاعاتي رح يصير حتى قبل ايش ما صار بس ما عرفتش بالضبط ايش ما عرفتش انه الاشي العاطل جاء عجر يحيى يحيى كان ولدي منيح اللي بحياته ما أذى حدا انقتل عشان اشي ما دخلوش فيه نقتل عشاننا
Jag går ner med, jag gör mig lycklig hela mitt liv, visst du det? Kom ner. Det är min man, selvfølgelig. Det är George. George, som är ett annat sted ute i mörket. George, som är god vid mig, som jag håner. George, som förstår mig, som jag støder frem mig. George, som kan få mig till att grine, selvom jag inte vinner ham. George, som holder om mig om natten og gør mig varm. Og som jeg bider til blod. George, som lærer sig spillereglerne hurtigt, jeg kan nå at få lavet dem om. George, som vil gøre mig lykkelig. Selvom jeg vil være ulykkelig. Nej! Jeg vil være lykkelig! George og Martha.
Det var dog.
ما بتروح
ولا نخلص نتوت
ازاي اذكر التوت هو مات ازاي توت ازاي دفار اخي افي اخي متيش ايش
Te doen we drinken wel uit flesje. Dat is een typisch Belgisch, hè? Uit flesje drinken.
Dat is ook typisch. Zie je dat?
Zo. Op Irak!
Iran. Wij zijn van Iran, hè?
Belduk!
Ja! Op België!
Op Roy Orbison!
Je doet Charlie mee.
Förälskelse eller den där den sortens extas eller vad man nu ska kalla det men vad är det egentligen det är ju ingenting
ingenting
nej och jag kan till och med känna mig glad att du och jag vi har kommit mycket längre det är den punkt där vi bygger ju vår relation på någonting mer solitt en känsla som går mycket djupare Och som faktiskt bara blir djupare och djupare ju mer åren går.
Eastman Kodak has been a valued sponsor of the Hamptons International Film Festival for many years. They support this award, which honors the artistry of the cinematographer with a $6,000 worth of film stock. And I now will get an envelope. And say that the award for best cinematography goes to The Misfortunates, directed by Felix van Groningen, and cinematography by Ruben Impens. I think someone is there from we're here.
Thank you very much. We'll buy some, oh, so thank you for the film stock. It's maybe a bit cynical that we shot it completely digital, next film I'll shoot on film. Thanks.
The Zuckerman Family Foundation joins us again with their award for screenwriting with the cash prize of $5,000. And there's a thing. And it goes to The Misfortunates, directed by Felix van Groningen, screenplay by Felix van Groningen and Christoph Dierks. Felix is here to accept the award.
Well, great, beautiful. It was a great speech there. I would like to repeat it. This is amazing, really. Thank you, and I should, for the previous prize, of course, thank my DOP, Ruben Impens, and for this prize, Woo! Christoph Dirix, who co-wrote the script with me, and it was based on a beautiful book also. Thank you.
And now for the Golden Starfish Award for Best Narrative Feature Film. To present the award, I'd like to ask back to the stage Thelma Adams.
Are you clapping for me or that it's almost the end of the evening? I've got to say we had a terrific jury and there was very little conflict and an easy resolution. Our special jury award, before I get to the final award, we'd like to give a special jury award to, please. Okay, I know what it is. So, Outstanding Achievement by an Actor, Paprika Steen, from Applause. She's here, isn't she? Yeah, come on down. We call her. We call her the Danish Sharon Stone. Come on, baby.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Thank you very much. I'm surprised. I didn't even know there was a special.
It's for you.
Mission.
We did it for
thing.
You.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, everybody that was in the. That was the jury that decided that. Thank you, everyone. I can't. I don't know English. I don't know names. Thank you. But first of all, thank you, Marty, to, you know, give me the award and give me the part, and my husband and my son and
Otto
and Michael, and yeah, great. I'm going to come back. Thank you.
Congratulations. Our pleasure.
Okay, thank you.
Now, the big award. Here we go. We are very fortunate to present this to The Misfortunates, directed by, we know him already, and he's promised me his sweater for giving him this award, Felix van Groeninger. This film is the Belgian nominee for the Academy Awards, and it is a comedy about alcoholism. As we saw, go beer. Thank you.
Thank you.
Our pleasure. And behind you is the.
I don't know what it is with this film. It just everything works out. It's really amazing. We finished it in March. Well, it wasn't even finished, and we sent it to Cannes, and it was accepted for the Cannes, the Directors' Fortnight, and then it got accepted to a whole lot of festivals, and it just come out in Belgium, and it's doing great in the theaters there, and now this. I mean, it's really, really, really amazing. I mean, I don't know. Sometimes I guess a film gets people by the balls, and I think this film does that, and it's out of my hands. But thank you, David Nugent, for inviting this film, and thank you, the Hamptons Film Festival, and I really want to thank my producer. This is my third feature with Dirk Impens, and thank you, Dirk. Thank you, everybody.
You've been watching WVVH's coverage of the Hamptons International Film Festival. You know, every local community has a film festival. Thank you for joining us for this one.
That's right. And if you want to join us next year, we hope you do at the 18th annual Hamptons International Film Festival. Please join us right here on Hamptons TV, WVVH. And for more information about this festival, contact the hamptonsfilmfest.org at their website.